The San Jose Sharks have shocked the hockey world in the playoffs. The Detroit Red Wings seek to avoid first-round elimination again. Tonight, it's number 1 versus number 8 in Game 7. Hervé stops the pucks for San Jose. Fedorov scores the goals for Detroit. Makarov is playing like a kid again. And Dino is scoring when it counts. The little Latvian, Artur Hervé, is San Jose's version of Patrick Waugh. Superstar ability in the nets. Sergei Makarov leads the San Jose offense in the series, 5 goals in 6 games. Steve Yzerman is finally back in the Detroit Red Wing lineup, and he's back on the scoring sheet. And playoff performer extraordinaire Dino Cicerelli is up to his old tricks. And don't forget 50-goal scorer Ray Sheppard. He can be a goalie's worst nightmare around the net. Will Super Sergei be smiling at night's end? Game 7 holds the answer. The San Jose Sharks are swimming into uncharted waters. Game 7 of a Stanley Cup playoff series. While the Detroit Red Wings have definitely been down this road before, 3 years in a row, 15 times in franchise history. Buckle your seatbelts. I think we're going to have a good one tonight. In goal for the San Jose Sharks, the little Latvian, I like to call him, Artur Hervé.
Well, Artur Hervé is a guy that has set an NHL record playing that many minutes, and throw away that myth that you're too small to be able to handle those kind of minutes, because Artur Hervé has been brilliant for the San Jose Sharks. Chris Osgood, meanwhile, here's the guy that just quite simply says, I don't worry about the pressures of Game 7. This is just another game. That's a great attitude to have.
Well, the head coach of the Sharks, Kevin Constantine, a former goaltender in his younger days. He's out of International Falls, Minnesota, coached the Kansas City Blades, the farm team, and, of course, the legendary Scotty Bowman behind the Detroit Red Wing bench, the winningest coach in National Hockey League history, and play is on here in Game 7. First goal in this game is going to be huge.
Very important. Very important for both goaltenders to have a favorite off the bat. Probably more so for Chris Osgood, being the younger guy on home ice, to get the feel of the puck.
Red Wings came out storming the gates in game number 6, and the Sharks were never in it. They'd like to forget that one and go back and play their style. Their style is dumping it out of trouble. He's Chason touches up for the icing. Scotty Bowman, the aforementioned coach of the Red Wings, trying to win a Stanley Cup again. He's been there before, been associated with 6 of them.
There's a lot of talk right now as to whether or not Scotty Bowman should be playing a defensive system, typical playoff hockey, or whether or not they should open it up and play the kind of hockey that has made the Detroit Red Wings one of the top teams in the National Hockey League this year. And in fact, Paul Coffey sort of went public with that statement thinking, hey, let's win it with what we have right now, and whether it's a 10-5 win or a 3-2 win, let's just play the kind of hockey we're capable of playing.
Well, the Red Wings had a 3-1 lead out of San Jose in Game 4, and they blew it. They blew the game, and it was after that that Coffey sort of exploded. He says, darn it, when we get a lead, let's try and get a bigger one. Let's not play defensively. Meanwhile, here comes Makarov for San Jose. Gives it back. The passing in front. They score! They score! San Jose is on the board. Johan Gorfinlov. It's 1-0 just like that.
That is exactly what the Red Wings did not want, but for Kevin Constantine and the San Jose Sharks, again, the brilliant production of their top 5 players in their lineup, world-class offensive players, Larionov, Garpenlov, and Makarov, and on this situation, you think that Larionov might shoot the puck, and you think, well, don't think too much, because it's Garpenlov coming up the middle in a wide-open, empty netter. Now, Osgood doesn't have a chance. He's got to move to his left. He's trying to take the one play away. Bang, it's a little empty netter, one tapper, and the Detroit Red Wings defensemen and forwards are just looking around, dazed and confused in their own zone.
Well, that's Garpenlov's 2nd goal of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Johan Garpenlov, the Swede, playing on the line with Marianov and Makarov, the 2 Russians, and Steve Yzerman puts one in on Artur Hervé. And so the Sharks got just what they wanted, the first goal of this game. Garpenlov dumps in. Osgood will leave it for his defenseman.
Well, if Osgood said he wasn't nervous before this game, it might have changed a little bit after that situation to give up the goal on the first shot.
He's primo, Darren. Didn't mean to interrupt you, but he gave it away to Ulf Dahlin. The Red Wings come back. Sheppard with a shot. It's wide. And the play was offside anyway, I believe, with 18:35 to go here in the first period. Well, Chris Osgood not getting off to the start he wanted. He had a tough one in Game 5, didn't he?
Well, Well, he didn't. He was pulled in that game. It was a 2-0 game, but he said afterwards, he says, don't question my confidence. Ask me if I'm lacking confidence. Chris Osgood is the kind of kid, almost to a naive point, that he won't get rattled. But Scotty Bowman has to have some kind of concern. It is not what they wanted to do, and that was break down defensively and allow a world-class line like Larionov and Makarov to get on the board early.
Faceoff in the San Jose zone. And the Sharks try and clear, and they do clear down to Terry Carter at center. Carter over to Mark Howe, who's playing despite a bad back. What else is new? Here's Chris Draper of Detroit. His centering pass is intercepted. The Sharks in their road teal with black and white trim. And that familiar logo has sold millions upon millions of dollars worth of souvenir apparel throughout the sporting world. Pat Kalun, one-time number one draft pick of the Sharks, comes into the corner. Darren McCarty is there for Detroit. You're just tuning in. The San Jose Sharks have a 1-0 lead in Game 7 at Detroit. It was 1 year ago tonight that the Red Wings played a Game 7 here in the playoffs against Toronto, and they lost it at home in overtime. A goal by Nikolai Borchessi. They don't want that to happen again. Terry Carter around the corner, but not out. Jason Moore keeps it in for San Jose. Pat Kalun with it in the corner. Fans getting on to Detroit Red Wings early. They're very vocal here, either for their team or against them. And if Detroit gets down anymore, they're really going to hear it. There's the San Jose bench.
San Jose at this morning's game, they were actually, and several of the players made comments about the fact that they looked a little more uptight than what they had normally been. And it was Todd Ellick that said, hey, we have to be relaxed. The pressure isn't exactly on us. Kevin Constantine, though, the head coach, that's just 35 years of age, says we're not going out there tonight thinking that this is going to be a fun game and let the cards fall where they may. We expect to win this hockey game, and they're off to the kind of start they needed to be off on, scoring a goal early. You see, San Jose does not have the type of offense that what the Detroit Red Wings have, so quite clearly, if they're behind two or three goals, they have a tough time coming back.
Face-off won by the Red Wings, and this is Nicholas Lidstrom. The Red Wings at practice this morning, very relaxed, almost in a jovial mood, while the San Jose Sharks were more focused and appeared to be tense at times. There's Ray Sheppard with a steal in the San Jose zone. Primo, not 100% physically, got nothing on that shot. Larionov behind the net. Cross ice to Sandis Ozolin. Got the National Hockey League All-Star team and did quite well in New York at the All-Star Classic. Primo sent away by Coffey, but he just couldn't get to it. That's the kind of offense Detroit will try and generate. San Jose, they're more of a counter-punching offensive club.
San Jose will try to take advantage of turnovers in the neutral zone and try to respond with three-on-twos and two-on-one situations like that.
Coffey dumps in. Hervé gets it finally over to Gaetan Duchesne. Duchesne, though, can't clear the zone. And Cicerelli in the corner. He's tied up with Vlastimil Krupa. Krupa hits Cicerelli again, and Duchesne walks away with him. Krupa's a big boy, well over 200 pounds. Puck goes into the Red Wing bench. Whistle for a faceoff. 1-0 San Jose early.
Daihatsu, Japan.
Motors, the international motorsport magazine. Eurosport brings you the best of motorsport. Every week, pictures and results from across Europe and the world. Motors is brought to you by Total Oils. Motors, Wednesday at 10 p.m. on Eurosport.
The San Jose Sharks already own a 1-0 lead. If we talked about the confidence that Osgood might have lacked on the first goal, this is a tremendous save. Sandis Ozilinch, another defenseman for San Jose, moving up in the play, and the Red Wings clearly are not anticipating or prepared for the guy coming up late.
Detroit shoots it in. Arthur Zerbe has it hop over his stick, and here is Fedorov centering, but nobody home for Detroit. Larionov couldn't control. This is Kartemov. Karl, Larionov, and Kartemov, a pretty effective first line for the Sharks, who really came on the second half of the year.
They're an outstanding line, Tom. They're just so great with the puck, the magician, starting with Makarov. And when you look at Larionov, his assets, and you'll find out his team, the man, he sees the ice so darn well, he can make a play.
Man, booing because the icing that was going to be called was waved off against San Jose. Peterson in the corner for the Sharks. Tom Peterson gets it back to center down the ice. But not far enough pricing, and Lidstrom behind his own net. We play just about 9 minutes of the first period, and the goal by Kartemov, 47 seconds into the game, has the Sharks on top. Darren McCarty winds up and hits the stick of Todd Ellis. Now with it comes Gaetan Duchesne. The Sharks don't look shook up early on, that's for sure. O'Dolan and a stick save on good. Ellis runs into him, knocks the goal off, and the Red Wings win interference, but they will not get it.
The National Hockey League has done a great job of calling the interference in the playoffs so far. Now, Ulf Dahlin has a situation where he makes a nice pass across, but the collision in front of the net by Todd Ellick on Osgood, that is what interference is about. A player is supposed to try to get out of the way as quickly as possible, but Andy Van Halen is setting the tone for this game. But as I said, the National Hockey League referees have done an excellent job during the course of this playoff.
Face off in the Detroit zone. Eisenman clears it out. Sean Coleman with it for the San Jose Sharks. Dumps behind the net for Osgood. Pat Balloon races for it. Doesn't get there, and Primo's there for Detroit. Here's Vladimir Konstantinov. Pass onside. Chipper is wide. Irvine may have gotten a piece of that. Steve Kayson from the point. Bob Airey recovers and just ices it down behind the goal, icing the call on San Jose.
Arthur Zerbe clearly got a stick on that little bit of a nifty shot by Ray Sheppard. Now Sheppard, 52 goals in the regular season. He gets hot when Steve Yzerman's his centerman, because Yzerman will get him the puck. Since Yzerman's return, Sheppard has 3 points in this series. But Sheppard in all alone. He's got himself, Cronin behind him, trying to give him a last-minute hook. And it is a solid save by Urbe. That is the last thing the Red Wings want to have happen, is for not only San Jose to score the first goal, but for Arthur Zerbe to get red hot. Because everybody here tells us that Arthur Zerbe hasn't played his best hockey. He played so well during the regular season, he hasn't caught fire here in the postseason. Wow, this one could be the game. You don't want to leave it to a Game 7 in that situation if you're the Red Wings.
No time like the present, though, if you're the Sharks, if Herbe's on his game.
Wow, one, a goalie. We've seen so many goaltenders do it. Makarov, meanwhile, he's another guy that can do it. He's going to take this face off on Draper.
See, the Red Wings have doubled the early shot on goal totals. Konstantinov with a shot to the point, and Draper almost tipped it by Herbe. Fedorov's playing without his helmet. Could be interesting if Fedorov takes a hit. Remember, took a hard hit from his own teammate late in the regular season. Sean Burns and Cooper took him a while to recover from that. Here's Draper with a hard hit on Norton, who's been a marked man early on. Fedorov behind the net. Irvay takes those chances. He covers up with 9:37 to go. And a faceoff in San Jose Dome.
Said faceoffs, Tom, how important are they? Both sides of the ice, it doesn't matter how much time is on the clock, you can generate a great offensive chance, or obviously you can clear your zone. Sergei Fedorov did not take this faceoff, it was Draper that took it, and won it cleanly off Makarov. Long shot from the point, little wee of a deflection, you see Draper going right to the net, Makarov didn't take him, Zerbe would have had no chance on that deflection, but Arthur Zerbe, cool, calm, and collected in that goal. Played 40, he set that record for most. I was unaware that that was the record, but boy, I was unaware that he had played so much this year.
Well, Coffey got the faceoff, but his pass attempt hit the traffic in front, and Ulf Dahlin clears it down the ice. In case you're confused on the promo, the Bruins-Devils game is on tomorrow on ABC, 1 o'clock Eastern, noon Central and Pacific. 1 Eastern, noon Central and Pacific for Boston, New Jersey, game 1 of the Eastern semifinal on ABC, and then on the Deuce tomorrow night on ESPN2, Washington and New York. Game 1 of that Eastern semifinal, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific time. All right. Back to business here in Detroit. 9:05 to go in the first. There's a loose puck intercepted and dumped in by Jamie Baker. But only for a line change. And Coffey passes it to Kozlov and over his stick. Icing will be the call on Detroit as Conan touches up in the corner.
Scotty Bowman, the head coach, Barry Smith, the assistant coach, already in this contest. 8:49 left in the first. They're down 1-0. He's already switched up his lines. He's got Steve Yzerman right now playing with Dino Cicerelli and Kozlov. That's the normal position for Fedorov. My question would be right now, is there something wrong with Sergei Fedorov? He took a hit in the offensive zone. He lost his helmet. But, I mean, Scotty Bowman's not afraid to mix up his lines. Yzerman had been playing with Keith Primo and Ray Sheppard, and that line, in fact, from Christmas time on had been terrific for the Detroit Red Wings. Now Yzerman centering again. As I said, now he's got Primo and Ray Sheppard with him now.
Face off to the right of the goaltender Chris Osgood for Detroit, who has supplanted Bob Essensen now firmly. Osgood, the number one goaltender for the Red Wings. Essensen, the man they traded for late in the season, and he's relegated to backup, at least for now. Yzerman forechecked nicely by Whitney, and now the Red Wings will break out. Big Primo at center, poke checked away there by Jamie Baker. Osgood around the corner up to Yzerman. Picked off again at center by Whitney. 8 minutes, 12 seconds to go, first period. San Jose and Detroit, game seven, and the Sharks lead at 1-0. Here's a loose puck intercepted by Makarov. He breaks in, he'll go to the backhand, and Osgood will save. Sergei Makarov, who years started with that Central Red Army team, he's very dangerous.
Forehand or backhand, that was an excellent play by Makarov, but Osgood followed him all the way.
Garpenlov is sent in by Makarov, but he's cut off. The fans getting impatient with the Red Wing defense. Here's Igor Larionov. Larionov down the slot. He's by McCarty, and McCarty finally has to tie up his stick. Pinching in from the point is Ozolink, but it's over his stick, and here comes Don Burr. Burr waits for his teammates. Draper is in front. Draper can't get good one on a shot. Comes to McCarty at center. Lazy pass off the boards, lucky it wasn't intercepted by Larionov. Base has slowed down perceptibly from what it was about 4 minutes ago.
Anytime that line's on the ice for Sandoz. Oh, what a collision. Burr and Duchesne went down. We're going to see the first penalties of the game.
And Van Helleman is signaling open that penalty box door. Now, Sean Burr is not reluctant to hit anybody, but Gaetan Duchesne is going over the penalty box for San Jose.
He's got him for an elbow. You heard Andy Van Helleman say it. Burr's going to go off and Duchesne's going to go off. So it'll be a four-on-four situation. As you see, clearly. Burr gave him an elbow, and then Duchesne came up with the high stick. But before that, another turnover in the neutral zone. Capitalized on it as Makarov coming in one-on-one. Decides to back away to the backhand a little bit, trying to go through the legs of the five-hole of Osgood. Osgood followed him all the way. And we've already got our first one on the ice. A tradition since 1952. It's an octopus.
That's right. Well, Duchesne is wiping out the visor so he can get a better look at this fish or this mammal, this octopus, whatever it is. Now, you notice that nobody's rushing to pick it up. That's for two reasons. It smells and it's slimy. And there's the guy. Well, I got to give him the nod. He's wearing gloves. Long-standing playoff tradition here in Detroit.
Arthur Zerbe had the best line in game one here, and he felt there was a turning point to this game when Detroit was all over the Sharks. An octopus came on the ice, and it really slowed down play. And he asked at the end of the game, what was the key to the game? And he said that. The octopus, well, he said the seafood on the ice was the key to the game.
The seafood. All right. Face off in the San Jose zone. Peterson wins it back for Westfield Krupa. Krupa tied up. Taken away by Fedorov in front, and Lidstrom fans on a great centering pass from Sergei Fedorov. 4-on-4, you think this would favor Detroit. Well, the open ice, Pumpy the shot, wide stick side.
Bowman has Fedorov and Yzerman on with Lidstrom and Coffey. I think that's a wise choice by Bowman to have all four of those features on the ice.
Norton behind his own net, looking to center. Larionov. 6:15 and counting left in the period. 1:18 and counting left in the coincidental minors. DeBoer and Gaetan Duchesne. Here comes Makarov at center. Makarov to the backhand again. He scores! 6th goal of the playoffs, and oh man, do we have a story developing here.
Not a very good goal at all. A weak backhand play under the stick of Osgood. He moved it prematurely and it went right through his legs. Oh boy, this is the kind of, these are the kind of goals that can break a team's morale after Detroit's trying to get right back into it. Heads up play by Makarov again. The second time in this period he goes to the backhand, and clearly Osgood just really whiffed on this one. Went to use his stick and kick the puck to the corner. Kicked it out way too soon and right through the legs. Now the Detroit Red Wings have a mountain to climb already. And you think, well, it's early in this game and they're only down 2-0. But the longer San Jose can play with the lead, the more confidence that Kevin Constantine is going to relay to them on the bench. And they've rallied all year long in close games. They've performed well under pressure in close games this year.
So much for my theory about the open ice saving Detroit. Makarov gets his 6th goal in the playoffs. You're right there. That was a bad goal to give up for Chris Osgood. Well, the Red Wings faithful teetering now on the brink, starting to boo their heroes as Draper's shot is shanked and comes in on the goaltender Irbe, who covers up for a faceoff. 2-0 Sharks. The San Jose Sharks, once just a logo, now they're starting to get some recognizable names. And their coach, Kevin Constantine, the redhead from International Falls, Minnesota, what a job he's done. I asked him, you were blown out in game 6-1 or 7-1. How do you get over that? He says, if you forget the past, you might lose one eye. If you dwell on it, you'll lose both. He says, we're going to forget game 6 happened. We're going to come out. It's 0-0 at the start. We're going to play our game. And he was very confident this morning.
Very confident person, a very intense person, but the pressure really clearly is on this guy, Chris Osgood, and what he has to do right now to get himself back in is, you see the numbers of game 5, 2 goals on 2 shots, 2 goals on 4 shots. After game 5, he said, maybe if they don't pull me, we come back and win that hockey game. That's how confident he is, but clearly he has to make a save here, and a big save. Not an easy save, he's got to make another big save as he did after the first goal went in.
Nicholas Lidstrom at center on the left wing to Eiserman. I think it's imperative for Detroit to get the next goal here for their confidence, if nothing else. Lidstrom's got a good shot to the point. Shepherd deflected it wide. With that lead now, Darren, the San Jose Sharks have the perfect situation for them to play their game, which is counterpunch all night long. Ozolin gets it into Norton for a shot, and it's wide stick side. Sean Burr at center. It'll be taken back by Ulf Dahlin. Sharks come in as the 8th seed. Detroit come in as the 1 seed. In the Western Conference. Sean Burr dumps it for Irbe. Sheldon Kennedy can't control, and it's Dolph Dahlin at center. Nice pass by Dahlin to Todd Ellick, and the pads are closed this time by goaltender Osgood.
Once again, the San Jose Sharks, fairly creative in the neutral zone, capitalizing on a 3-on-2. Long shot, Ellick and Dahlin have moved the puck around awfully well. Dahlin on the right-hand side going to his backhand, right to Ellick. Ellick with the long shot. It's a good move by San Jose. Now try to test the young goaltender, see if he's jittery at all. But Osgood had no problems with that one. Todd Ellick was a waiver pickup on October 26th from the Edmonton Oilers. What an outstanding pickup that was by the Sharks.
They did their homework on that one, didn't they?
Ended up with 25 goals in the regular season.
Here's Steve Chason breaking out for Detroit. Draper to big Bob Colbert. He cruises in but can't control it. Colbert now, they give him plenty of room, don't they? Not a bad idea. Irbe gets the first shot, rebound in the slot, is sticked aside. And Chason keeps it in the zone. And he gives it away, and here comes San Jose 2-on-2. Dahlin likes to take the long shot off of Chason's stick into the crowd. Bob Probert, here's a guy that can stir this crowd up, maybe get the momentum back in Detroit's favor.
Bob Probert is capable of doing that, and when he gets energy going and starts taking out the body, this big, lumbering, gentle giant off the ice, on the ice, he really can go, obviously, but Bob Probert, he initiated things after San Jose got up 1-0 in this game. It was Bob Probert that labeled a couple of the San Jose Sharks, including Jeff Norton, with good open ice hits. Holds the Red Wing record for points in one playoff year, 21.
The
big year for a big playoff series also for Bob Clover, because the rumors he might be moving on. Other teams are definitely interested in these services.
Well, he's played out his option, so that, you know, the Red Wings would still have the right to match any offers came his way, which there will be plenty.
Yes, there are. Locked loose in the Detroit zone. Coffey behind his own net. Sean Cronin shoots it right back in. Nicholas Lindstrom. Coffey. Fedoros hit by Cronin at center, but not hard. Here's Paul Coffey. Well, the Sharks are standing up for that blue line, aren't they? They make it almost impossible for the Red Wings to skate the puck in.
Excellent job of reading the play. Bob Airey just jumping up at the blue line, almost startling Paul Coffey. And you're right, that would force the Detroit Red Wings to dump the puck in, something that they don't like to do as a team.
They'd rather not do it. Offsides on Dino Cicerelli. 2-0 San Jose. Goals by Garpanov and Makarov have Bob Probert and the Red Wings singing the blues on the bench, down 2-0 in Game 7 of the Stanley Cup quarterfinal, live on ESPN's National Hockey Night. The winner goes on, the loser goes home. And the Red Wings, after blowing out the Sharks 7-1 in Game 6, there the media, both print and electronic, almost treated this game as a foregone conclusion here in Detroit. Surprised me after what we've seen earlier in the series.
Well, every first round for the last 3 years, the Red Wings have had to contend with a seventh game, losing 2 of the 3. A lot of pressure on the Red Wings and the franchise to win this game.
On the right wing, the shot taken by Konstantinov hits traffic in front. Well, the Sharks do a good job staying in front of their goaltender, Irvé, and moving people out of the slot area, holding the shots to the wing, much like Toronto did the other night against Chicago. Marianov carries in. He's onside. Ozilic is going to the net. Makarov, he's forced to dump in. Osgood to Konstantinov with Duchesne right on his tail. Tom Peterson back in his own zone. Wolf Dahlin winds up and hits.
Oh, my. Konstantinov just hit his arm.
Had to hurt. Under 2 minutes to go, first period. Red Wings dump it down, and Elvigeli of icing as Krupa touches up, and the booze cascade from the sellout crowd of almost 20,000.
Alf Dahlin picked up in a trade with the Dallas Stars regular season, 25 goals and 69 points. Really helped their power play. Terrific at moving his feet along the boards. He's a great boardsman, and he's playing on the line with Todd Ellick and Gaetan Duchesne.
Based off of the Detroit zone, Greg Johnson is replaced in there by Darren McCarty. McCarty and Ellick. Ellick controls it into the corner. Alf Dahlin, who always does good work along the boards, comes away with it but can't get the shot away. Colbert trying to do some forechecking and force a turnover. And here's Colbert. Dish off to McCarty. And McCarty is bodied off by Peterson. McCarty wanted a penalty, but Van Helleman says play on. Bouncing puck. Finally cleared out of the zone there by Vlastimil Krupa. Here's Martel. Now takes a hard hit from Airy well after he got rid of that puck. Irvé behind his net gives it away. Oh, Archer Irvé very lucky as he gave it right to the stick of Kozlov. Last minute of play here in the first period. And the sound you hear in about a minute, Darren, will not be cheers for the home team as they leave the ice. Fedorov sets Kozlov down the slot. Kozlov shoots. Irvé to save. Archer Irvé with a save of the game so far.
What a great save using his right foot on a very tricky Kozlov.
Penalty coming up on the Red Wings. And oh my goodness, Fedorov went headhunting. That could be a major. He flat out went headhunting against Jason Moore. That's a vicious, vicious penalty by Sergei Fedorov. Don't know what precipitated it. I haven't seen him lose it like that, Darren, all year.
Well, he came across hard with a cross check right to the head of Jason Moore, and it was already the Red Wings that were going to be shorthanded because of a penalty being called. And, oh, in the back, oh, a right shot by Moore. And, oh, a right paw by Kucherov as well. That was going to be the call right there, the roughing. And there's the cross check. Oh man, that's a vicious hit by Fedorov.
It is.
He'll be fortunate to be seen in this contest.
Can you imagine? Well,
that's the last thing the Red Wings need, is their big guy losing their composure like that in such a crucial hockey game. But just before that, Kozlov had just an outstanding chance, busting through the middle, trying to go into the forehand. Now Kozlov takes it from the backhand to the forehand, and just a great save by Urbe, anticipating that with his right pad. And again, late in the period, obviously that would have been a huge boost for the Detroit Red Wings if they would have been able to nullify that two-goal deficit, make it 2-1. Kozlov was nullified.
Well, they first flashed up 4 minutes on the penalty clock, which frankly didn't surprise me, although it didn't enlighten the crowd here, didn't make them happy. Now they've changed that to a two-minute penalty on Sergei Fedorov. Maybe they called four on Fedorov and two on the San Jose Shark. This is a dangerous play, Darren.
Goodness, there's an intent to injure situation.
And
clearly, without anybody around, they'd already had an altercation. They should have both gone on for roughing to begin with. And somehow, I don't understand this, because if he only got 2 minutes for cross-check, now everybody's standing up at the penalty box, and I'm not sure if nobody in for San Jose, but there was already going to be a penalty called for roughing on Fedorov. The hand was up from Andy Van Helleman.
Well, Moore has been called 2 minutes for roughing, so he's been assessed a penalty. And Fedorov gets 4 minutes for cross-checking, so it's a two-minute power play for San Jose. Coming up at our first intermission, the Dodge Intermission Report. We'll have a look at the Canucks Flames preview, their series. They're going to a seventh game tonight in Calgary. And a wrap-up of the first round of the Eastern Conference. And what great goaltending we had in the Boston-Montreal series and the New Jersey series as well. There is Moore. He's in the box, but he's only in there for two. Fedorov's in there for four.
The puck went all the way in the offensive zone, and there was no whistle being called. I thought the initial one was going to be on Fedorov, but I guess Andy Van Helleman, they both go off, and then Fedorov gets that extra 2 minutes for cross-checking.
Well, I agree with you, Darren. Sergei Fedorov is lucky to be in this game, because that is a vicious, vicious hit. And it may have been...
He knew what he was doing. He knew what he was doing. He came across hard, and...
We don't need that in this game. We don't.
There's a lot of things, and a lot of roughing things go on, though, and it's hard to keep it inside, Thomas. But in this kind of situation for Fedorov, they need him on the ice. They don't need him in the penalty.
Yeah. You hear it all the time. Keeping our focus. Loose puck in front. They score! Hit the ice.
Well, if the Red Wings needed a spark, this was clearly it. 12 seconds left on a giveaway. Draper, an innocent-looking backhand. That puck was on end, and somehow it eluded Urbe up through the armpit on the right-hand side through the blocker in the body. Just an innocent-looking tap-in. Great perseverance, though, by Sean Burr and by Draper. Draper's a speedy player, anticipated the play, and again, the second one crawls onto Joe Louis Arena ice. And man, they're painting it red here.
Look at the size of that squid.
It's got some braids on it.
Get that fish a haircut. Well, actually, three different octopi came on the ice. And did that change the mood of this crowd or what? An innocent-looking play, a giveaway in the San Jose zone.
And Fedorov in the penalty box.
Yeah, that's right.
Short-handed goal, especially teams, are so important. Chris Draper gets his second goal of postseason play.
That'll stun the San Jose Sharks. Let's see if they lose a little bit of composure. I think it's a good thing for the Sharks that the end of the period is coming up in 2 seconds. And Sean Burr just buries one of the Sharks. That's Krupa. And Chris Draper getting his temper going. That was Sean Burr who buried Krupa. And there is Chris Draper, who's got to be a happy young man. Chris, put the foul card back in here on TV. The period has ended. Referee Andy Van Helleman trying to make sure that cooler heads prevail here. Sean Burr got cranked up and gave a perfectly hard and legal hit at the end of the period.
Well, Sean Berzline has been doing that the entire period, really lifting them up. As you take a look at one of the keys to the San Jose Sharks, Johan Garpenlov, a former Detroit Red Wing.
Garpenlov and Makarov for San Jose. It was 2-0 until lightning struck in the last 13 seconds. First period statistics, nary a power play opportunity officially because we had some 4-on-4 play. However, the Sharks will be on the power play early here in the second period. Actually, I think there is, yes, there was a power play opportunity at the end there. The statistics weren't completely correct. Shots on goal 9-5 in favor of the Detroit Red Wings. So Fedorov remains in the penalty box at the end of the first period. Elika, San Jose, and Coffey of Detroit. That was the scrum at the end. They got each 2 minutes for cross-checking.
Right.
So they'll cool their skates for the first 2 minutes here of the period. It is a 5-on-3 situation, a 4-on-3 situation right now for the San Jose Sharks.
Five on four with what has just transpired. Confusing because it all happened in the end, but the Sharks will go on their first power play of the game.
2-1 San Jose, the Sharks on the road. First playoff appearance ever, trying to do what many people felt was impossible. Derail the Detroit Red Wings, the highest scoring team in the National Hockey League. Makarov has it taken away, but gets it back to Norton. Norton over to Sandis Ozolin. Makarov, Varianov, Ozolin, 54 seconds to go. Ozolin right into the chest protector, lies good. Oh, bodies are colliding. It's Steve Treson knocking down Johan Garpenlov.
Norton's shot from the left point was clearly too high, and in those types of situations, as a defenseman, it's probably best to keep it down so a goaltender can't control the rebound. Oskar, though, got a good grip on the rebound. Now, Norton has the shot. Now, he does have to try to get it up above Draper, who's killing the penalty and trying to shut down that shot. Nice protection by the Red Wings. Treson hammering down Garpenlov. But again, the puck got up a little bit too high on Norton. Probably not the choice that he would prefer. And Oskar does a nice job of corralling it. You see Treson and Garpenlov taking care of business right in front of the net.
Face off in the Red Wings zone to the right of Chris Osgood. 50 seconds now to go in the extra 2 minute minor to Sergei Fedorov. Sharks trying to take advantage of Fedorov's lack of judgment late in the first period. And Detroit ices it down to Archer Zerbev. 30 seconds left to go on the Shark power play. This is Igor Larionov. Ulf Dahlin sticks it to the corner, but Konstantinov is there. He avoids the hit from Makarov. Now Makarov behind the net. Yzerman is there to take it away and clear the zone.
Good play by Steve Yzerman, killing off the penalty, but Makarov again trying to go right up the middle. Boy, he's the magician with the puck, and he does the obvious, and so often it works. On that case, Yzerman read it perfectly.
Jamie Baker carries in. Fedorov will be out in 2 seconds, and Treson has it. The penalty is over. McCarty was serving the extra 2 minutes, so he'll leave the box. Irbe still has it. Thought he was going to hang on for a faceoff, but no. He's puck at center. Chris Draper jumps into the zone. McCarty gives the right shoulder to Krupa. Boy, Krupa's a big guy, but he's drawn a lot of hits in his hockey game so far. Puck at center. Sean Burr with it for Detroit. Frank Johnson. He'll skate in, but he's 2-on-3. Johnson pulls up, waits for help, takes the shot himself, and Irving had a quick rebound, but Cicerelli goes wide. Here's Kozlov. Kozlov in the slot. He won't shoot. Kozlov behind the net. The wraparound, and Irving saw it coming. Konstantinov with a drive, and it's blocked by the defense. Another shot. Irving in the save. It's loose. He scores!
Thank you.
a couple of scoring chances. Again, with the traffic in front, Bob Airy had just made a terrific block for the Sharks. But the rebound comes through on Irby after the initial save. Johnson does some dirty work, and it's Kozlov that sneaks around on the backhand and taps it on into the empty net.
Now they're blaring over the PA system the Rhythm and Blues song, I Feel Good. And the Red Wings have got to feel great after they dug themselves a two-goal hole. They're now back in it. Another squid hit the ice, or octopus, if you will.
Again, though, the speed of the Detroit Red Wings, their transition game and speed, that's been their asset all year long. Kozlov with the initial play on the back end, nullified by Urbe. Constantino, the first shot, but you know, he stuck with the rebound after Airy had already blocked it, and then Kozlov taps her home on the back end.
And Greg Johnson and Dino Cicerelli doing yeoman work in front, bothering Arthur's Urbe. The official on that is Kozlov and Constantino at 2:36.
Yeah, you're right, though. Cicerelli should get a whole lot of credit again in the face of Urbe. It's the intention of many, many teams in the playoffs where no goaltenders can get hot, and you try to get in front of them as often as possible.
So San Jose and Detroit tied at 2. Who's going to grab more? On the table now. Eisenman in the corner. Primo's in front, but Eisenman is bumped off. And for San Jose, it's Pat Balloon. Balloon has it poke checked away by Chiesa. And Steve Eisenman drawing a tough body check. Here's Shepard to Primo. Survey to save. One thing I've noticed about Arthur Derbe, he does give up rebounds, doesn't he?
Well, he tries to get him in a position to stay up and square with the shooter, and yeah. Quite frankly, they bounce off those big pillars of his. And on that situation again, shot by Primo. Urbe with the save, but a big rebound.
Well, Keith Primo got a good shot away on Urbe, and he had to be tough.
Well, after Eisenman made a hit on Whitney, then the Shepherd all the way over to Primo. Primo with a quick shot, trying to go short side on the stick side. Nobody to clear that rebound. Jamie Baker and a fire it down the other end of the ice. Primo, as you had said, look at that eye. Players are just so beat up in playoffs, and there's so many hidden injuries. High-low shots, low on Urbe, they're going 10 times, high twice, and they've scored on both times on the high side. I mean, Urbe covers the low part so well. The contention is that a guy's little used to go high. I don't believe in that whatsoever. But I believe with Urbe, the way he goes down, that he's empty from that area.
Well, the Red Wings buzzing around again in the Sharks zone, but Karpinov carries out. He's double-teamed and fights through it. Johan Karpinov. Trying to center. He's tied up. And finally, Chiesa sweeps it aside to center. Karpinov did a nice job there trying to create a scoring play. I think this is where the young Sharks are going to have a challenge here, as we're going to have a penalty call by Andy Van Helleman on Detroit.
Italy plays host to the World Ice Hockey Championship, and it's all live on Eurosport. The new Olympic champions Sweden take on reigning world champions Russia and 10 other nations, including Canada, Finland, and the United States.
Skoda, the official main sponsor of the Ice Hockey World Championship 1994.
The World Ice Hockey Championship, every day at 4 p.m. and 8 p.m. on Eurosport.
Jeff Norton sits in the penalty box for San Jose, an elbowing penalty at 3:48, and now the Sharks are tempting fate. Their poise is going to be tested here.
Sure will, and the power play of Detroit on home ice, 25%, third best this year in postseason play.
The San Jose Sharks, again in the year, not anybody gave them a chance to make the playoffs. When they made the playoffs, nobody gave them a chance to give Detroit a series. Well, here we are in the seventh game, and we're tied at 2. But the Red Wings are coming on. You can feel it. Eisenman keeps it in the corner. Detroit power play has Cicerelli out there with Lidstrom, Coffey, Eisenman, and Primo. They make that Fedorov. Fedorov is out there. Fedorov.
That was the stick of Duchesne on Fedorov.
He fell over the stick of Duchesne, but Van Helleman says that's not a penalty. I'm not going to call it.
Duchesne came up with a high stick, and it looked like it went off the shoulder of Fedorov and just clipped him. And that's when Fedorov went down.
Here's Eisenman on left wing. Comes around for Primo. Cicerelli back to the point, but Paul Coffey wasn't in the right place. Here's Fedorov getting attention on the Red Wing bench.
He's taken a beating so far in this playoff. Left in the last game, but returned in the third period with a bad leg.
Slava Kozlov dumps in. 50 seconds left on the Norton penalty of San Jose. Larionov does a good job clearing the zone. Larionov takes it away from Primo.
Is he good or what?
Yeah, or
Larionov is so intelligent with the puck, and he's able to poke check and still control it. Man, is he having a great year and a great playoff for San Jose.
You're not one of the dominant players in the Central League Army team without being talented. Just think of that, Makarov and Larionov and those guys.
Oh, terrific. Now, some of the pluggers, so to speak, for the San Jose Sharks would definitely be Duchesne, Gaetan Duchesne, and his stick right now as the Red Wings are on the power play. There it is, the blade of his stick right up high around the right ear, right eye section of Fedorov, and he fell down, and you know, you didn't see it, but Duchesne right away sort of had his arms up like, hey, I didn't mean to do that.
Yeah.
And Andy Van Helleman, I'm not sure if he even saw what happened.
No,
Fedorov just sort of fell over, sort of timbered over, and fell to the ice, and Fedorov then went right to the bench, but it looks like he's okay. Near the end of the regular season, he also took a clip up high, and he was very fortunate that didn't get him right on the eyeball.
I don't think Andy Van Helleman saw that. It's impossible for any referee to see everything that goes on out there, and that happens so fast, I just don't think he saw it. 25 seconds to go in the Norton penalty. 2-2 hockey game. Red Wings scored in the last 13 seconds of the first period and early here in the second to tie it up. Primo at center. Boy, he's imposing all 6'5 of him, and offside is Ray Sheppard. Feeling on the Shark bench, you have to wonder what's going through a team that hasn't had a lot of playoff, in fact, no playoff experience until this year.
You see the number 34 on the side. That's in honor of Mike Coleman, who passed away, and he was a member of the farm club of the San Jose Sharks, the Kansas City Blades. And in honor of him, they put that number 34 on the left side of their helmet.
Coleman tragically killed in an automobile accident. Too long ago. You know, we have a lot of viewers in Kansas City watching tonight, rooting for the San Jose Sharks. A lot of these players on the team, including Arthur Zerbe, one-time members of the Kansas City Blades.
Kevin Constantine, the head coach that year.
A couple of years, he won an IHL title there in Kansas City. Red Wings were closing in for a shot in the slot, but it eluded them, and the penalty is over, and teams are back at even strength. And lost at center for San Jose. Bird for Detroit. Draper puck checked it away from Larionov. Here comes Lidstrom in front. The short side save and the glove save now by Irby, who holds on for the faceoff. 13:28 to go in the second.
Nicholas Lidstrom moving in. In the offensive zone, Lidstrom's known as that type of player, and he's been paired with Paul Coffey, and that's been a great influence for number five of the Red Wings. Sees a little bit of room, goes to the back end, figures, hey, what the heck, why don't I fire one on net and see if something doesn't happen or does happen, and Irby is able to not only lose his balance, but grab it with his mitt. But Nicholas Lidstrom, as I said before, a couple of years ago, he had the best plus-minus of the National Hockey League. He was a runner-up to Pavel Bure for Rookie of the Year. San Jose just one shot on goal in this second period. They're sort of on their heels, but I think you have to attribute a lot of that to the momentum and the emotion of the very fast and talented Detroit Red Wings.
Face off now to San Jose zone to the left of Arthur Zerbe. Fedorov will take it against Todd Ellick. And it ends up in the corner for San Jose Peterson. But not out. Carter with a drive, and Irby sticks in to the corner. Terry Carter, let her rip. Peterson again for San Jose. He's bumped off, and Ellick tries to clear, can't do it. Cicerelli in the corner. Nino Cicerelli never stops working when he's out there. Fedorov to the backhand, and Irby will cover up in the slide. 13:02 to go in the second. Game 7, tied at 2.
Motorcycling.
speed and great footwork by Kozlov, busting through on his backhand. His first chance is eliminated. Hervé makes a good save on the second wraparound attempt. But as I said, all is a result. Now, meanwhile, you've got a situation here where Konstantinov has the first shot blocked. You got to hand it to him for sticking with it. And he fires his second chance in here. Now, here's the key right here. The stick of Draper all over Krupa. Krupa's not able to get to the loose puck that's going to be right there. To the backhand, Kozlov goes. And that, of course, is the game-tying goal.
Well, Chris Osgood has only faced 12 shots in this game, and there's always the theory that for a goaltender to be at his best, Darren, he has to be into the game. He has to be fielding his share of shots. He hasn't fielded that many in this game.
Well, as Barry Melrose just told us, you've got to put the puck on net, and Hervé as well. Hervé's got a little bit more momentum, but neither one of these goaltenders has had a chance to dominate what has transpired so far in this game. So obviously a pivotal save is going to turn around this contest in a 2-2 game. Scotty Bowman, meanwhile, he's been through a ton of these sort of things. But, you know, I'm not sure, though, if you get used to this type of situation.
Tightening his tie a little bit. I'm sure his insides are turning, even though he's been through this a million times. Here we go. Game 7, period 3, tie score. With Darren Pang, I'm Tom Meese. Stanley Cup action can't get any better than this. Right here on ESPN. Who will move on? Who will go home? The Red Wings attacking. Sergei Fedorov. Cicerelli in the doorstep. Kozlov still without his helmet. I think he's got a Velcro job. It keeps coming off. He just likes to show everybody those curly locks.
They're really after Jason Moore. Kozlov and Moore had a little one-on-one. No penalty call.
Morton clears the zone for San Jose. The San Jose Sharks, biggest one-season improvement in National Hockey League history. One of the better teams in the entire league, the second half of the season. And everybody said, well, that's nice, but they'll be out in 4 or 5 against Detroit. Yes, again. What a year it's been for Kevin Constantine. Here comes Kharkhanov, who opened the scoring. Makarov. Konstantinov is there for Detroit. Here's Chason. Pulls up and centers to Primo, and Hervé is there. Eisenman leaves it for Chason, but Chason didn't read the play properly. Back the other way come the Sharks, a 3-on-2, a 4-on-2. Jeff Norton is in, he shoots, and Oscar got a piece of it. Ray Shepard clears the zone.
Turnover in one end results in another breakout situation by San Jose, and are they good at it? But Oscar was able to get a right pad on that puck before it deflected through his legs.
Here's Sean Byrne. It's a 2-on-2. Byrne Draper into the sharp zone. Byrne to the backhand, but he gives it away. As back-checking Duchesne was right there in the slot. Alf Dahlin golfs this one into the stands. Face-off will be into San Jose zone.
Well, Jeff Norton just had a glorious opportunity. Him and Ozolinch just paired together, and they always fire up in the play, jumping in the offense whenever they get an opportunity. And this is a result of a situation where there's a turnover in their own zone. In San Jose's zone, a turnover leads to a 3-on-2 sort of break, and Norton moves it again. And it looked like Carter might have got his stick on that shot and never did get through to Osgood. Again, you see the stick of Carter, and yes, he deflects it wide. So Norton's shot goes wide. But again, Osgood not feeling that puck. San Jose trying to get it on net on a pretty good offensive play by Norton.
Interception by Sheldon Kennedy, doing some nice work. Ties did break Johnson. Off Probert to the corner for Detroit. We'll see Todd Ellick when he knew Probert had the puck, he backed away. Won the no party. He's Probert again at center. Dahlin gives him a bump from behind. Here's Kennedy. Centering. Probert had his stick tied up by Peterson. At center ice for the San Jose Sharks is Todd Ellick. Dumps in the corner. Sheldon Kennedy is there for Detroit. Kennedy with a burst of speed. Intercepted at center by Coffey, who's up there. Detroit will go for a line change. The tension continues to get greater and greater with every second. Cicerelli almost sent Fedorov in on a break. Tie score, game 7, Stanley Cup playoff quarterfinal round. Nicholas Lidstrom, Kozlov to center. Sharks dump it out again, and coffee for Detroit.
Again, good coverage by San Jose, blocking up the blue line, getting three or four men at least back there, and really forcing the Detroit Red Wings to circle the wagon, either that or dumping it back out.
Kozlov, two on one.
Steve Levy back in our National Hockey Night studios. Time to clear up some accounting problems. We showed you Ronnie Stern goal. That made it 2-2. A minute four later, Fleury from the bad angle. 3-2 Calgary. They're on the power play.
Well, Neil Fleury has two of those three goals for the Flames.
I'm happy to say Barry Melrose loves Fleury, and Fleury's a little guy.
Well, now Barry has to figure out to get him with the LA Kings. You know? Right?
I was thinking I'd make a comeback for Barry.
Way back onto the San Jose zone. Center with the Lariano, taken away by Burr. Makarov goes back into his own zone. 35 years young, Sergei Makarov. Taken away by McCarty. Ozolin to McCarty battling, or that Morgan McCarty battling for possession. Makarov comes away with it. McCarty. Stay by the cool Archer's Irvin. Take that one out of the air like a cherry on a tree.
Piece of cake on that one. Nothing in front for Irvin, but Dino Cicerelli, as he moves down on his bench, he had a glorious chance just moments ago on the reverse angle. Kozlov on his off wing, looking to feed and feather this nice little pass, but it takes one too many hops right over the tape of Cicerelli. One bounce right before it. Right over the tape. Otherwise, Cicerelli had an open net.
In the faceoff, but it's taken by San Jose's Krupa. Not the center. Todd Ellick races Mark Halfort. How that bad back slams into the sideboard. Now giving it a go tonight. Spent 3 or 4 days a week in traction at a local hospital. Just he was able to have his back frozen up in time to play. Rebo. Is Shenfrey. Paul Coffey with it. Back to Primo. Todd Ellick, mucking and grinding in the corner. Primo comes away with it. Yzerman the drive. His traffic goes over the net. Yzerman missed the first four games of the series with a knee injury suffered in the final regular season game in Dallas. 14:40 to go. Tied at two.
Yzerman, of course, one of the key players for Detroit, but so far, of course, the game, he's only had one shot on goal. That came in the first period.
Jason Moore taken back by Coffey. Fedorov takes a big hit from Moore. Those two just don't like each other very much. Either that or they have a way of bumping into each other.
They go again.
Yep, Fedorov the odd elbow to the ribs of Moore. Here comes Kozlov. He's dead. Whitney back the other way, taken away. Cicerelli to the trailing Coffey. Look at him go. The shot by Fedorov, the save, Irvin.
Well, the engine goaltending right now. Archer Gervais made some great saves, and Osgood hasn't faced a sniff in this second, third period.
Good point, Darren. You have to wonder, don't you? And it's not his fault. I mean,
no, first one for him will be very important, though. I'm sure he's anxious to touch that biscuit.
Detroit's doing a good job keeping the shots away from him. Ozolin. Oh, dangerous slot pass to Makarov. Lariat off at center. He's double teamed and taken away by Draper. High bouncing puck in the slot. Morton comes away with it for San Jose. This is Makarov. Poke check by Darren McCarty from his belly. And McCarty with it at center. Larionov always has that stick on the ice. Broke up with one. Vladimir Konstantinov. Double team and shifts it right into the shark bench. Look out. Those aren't the cheap seats, but they can be dangerous. A whistle stops play with 12:43 to go in the third, still tied at two.
One of the guys on San Jose's bench, though, looked like he might have taken that errant puck. He's bending over. I can't tell exactly who it is. But just before that, Kozlov again, utilizing his speed, one-timer to Lidstrom, and a real good save by Irvin. And who's he had to contend with? Got to contend with Dino Cicerelli going in front of him, looking for a screen and a deflection. Thrown it and hammered Cicerelli. Good end-to-end rush by Kozlov.
11 Canadians, 5 Americans, 3 Russians, 2 Latvians, 2 Swedes, and 2 members from the Czech Republic. And 25 bodies all pulling in the same direction. That's the San Jose Sharks. And Kevin Constantine, their coach, deserves untold credit. 35-year-old runs the show and has everybody pulling on the same page. That's tough enough to do when they all speak the same language, Darren. Peterson has it taken away. Detroit has Eichmann in front. Primo, though, can't get to it. Here's Shepard. And Irvin covers up on the soft shot by Shepard with Primo on the doorstep.
Again, Irving smothering up the rebound. Not a very hard shot, but nonetheless, it got through. Any puck that gets through traffic can be a dangerous situation. Irving comes up with a save, his 23rd shot of the evening, 21 of 23. Meanwhile, over on the bench, that was Makarov that took an errant puck, and he just had a towel by his mouth. And boy, that would be a huge loss for the San Jose Sharks. Karov, obviously an integral part of their... Well, it's a complicated offense when he's on the ice because of the way that they can maneuver with the puck in the offensive zone. I mean, for Detroit, that's the line that causes havoc, no question about it. So for Primo and the rest of the Detroit Red Wings, that is the one line.
Our Stanley Cup summary. Midway through the third period of Game 7, Calgary-Vancouver, the series 9-3. But in the Game 7, last score we had 3-2 in favor of Calgary. Toronto moves on. They beat the Blackhawks 4-2. And it seems like a year ago that the Dallas Stars swept the St. Louis Blues aside, doesn't it? It was actually 6 days ago.
Well, their golf game has improved since that time, I'm sure.
Yeah.
A lot of time off. And that can help and that can hurt. You can lose an awful lot of momentum as well. But if there's any minor injuries, you have a chance to heal them up. Shots on goal, 4-1 Detroit in this third period.
And the key there, only one shot on goal on Chris Osgood of Detroit. And that, too, could be a double-edged sword, as we've already said. All right, Fedorov taking the face-off for Detroit. Still struggling for it, and sweeping it out of the corner was Jamie Baker.
Baker's done a nice job on face-off for San Jose.
Captain Bob Barry in center. Barry cruises into the zone. Loses control of it. He's trying to go to his back end. And back come Detroit, Cicerelli. Fedorov on right wing. Fedorov around the defense, and Irvin hugs the post. Eyes off in the corner. He sends it to the crease. Coffey doesn't finish. And Whitney for San Jose just dumps into the corner for a line kick.
San Jose, they are reluctant as a team to shoot the puck anywhere in the quality area. They're just afraid to fire it for some reason.
Well, they're playing their style here in the third period. Counterattack. Take care of it. Wait for a mistake. Here's a mistake the other way. Sean Burr intercepting a clearing attempt, but San Jose covers up.
Yeah, how many times have we seen Detroit bust around with speed and try a wraparound and a pass in front of the net? And in every situation, San Jose has got a player or three there.
Makarov at center. Up into the corner for Konstantinov. Chason over his stick. No icing will be called here in Detroit. So Irvin goes ahead and plays it. Horton bumped hips with Sean Bird. Here comes Sandis Ozolin. Back to the left wing. Get Tander Shane and a glove save by Ryan Osgood.
Good save by Osgood. Long shot. Looked like that puck was rolling on Duchesne. Their first shot on goal, really. The first one deflected off the stick.
To the Detroit zone. 10:15 to go in regulation time. We're tied at 2. Game 7. Western Conference quarterfinal, Detroit and San Jose. Good the Sharks find some way to win this. I'd like to be a tavern keeper in San Jose, California tonight. Here's Todd Ellis. 1-on-3, and he's deep in the zone. Now he's buried by Markow. Jason Moore backhands it in right at Hal's head. Jason Moore keeps it in. But it's intercepted by Eiserman. Oh, nice pass by Eiserman, but Primo couldn't control it. Moore into the corner. On bounce in the slot, but Red Wings are there. Lidstrom dumps in the corner. That's the kind of bounce the goaltender can't take care of Cicerelli. And Whitney sweeps it out of the zone. Going to take a real big penalty for Van Halen to call it now.
You're right.
That's just the way it is, isn't it?
You're absolutely right. This is the time to hold and hook and grab the guy down.
Icing on the San Jose Sharks. We're still tied.
And Artur Zerbe's faced 24 shots. He's been having sort of an onslaught so far in the third period. Chris Osgood, though, has not faced any rubber, and that is the key for San Jose to get the puck on Osgood.
The tension mounts, and Erga didn't know where it was. And he thought he sat on it. It ended up behind the net. It's still in play. That has a crowd with the hearts in their throats. In the corner. 8:30 to go on regulation time. Detroit, I'm very wary of guys like Larionov and Nicaro, such skilled passers and stick handlers there.
Well, in this situation, as individuals for Detroit, you have to make sure you eliminate your man. They are very tricky.
Hervé and Burr meet in the corner. Net is open. Burr controls it, but Hervé's back. Artur Zerbe, Chuck Muzzlin. Intercepted by Eiserman.
Look, that stick work that goes on, huh?
Eiserman looking to center. Doesn't hit Chase on. Duchesne did a great job breaking that pass up. Now Osgood has to come out to clear the zone. A couple of Red Wings get tied up to the blue line. Here comes Dolan. Oh, Dolan shoots. And Osgood to save.
The majority of this game, man, did he just rob old Dolan.
My partner, Mr. Pang, a member in good standing of the Goaltenders Union, loves it when the little guys with the big sticks make the big save.
I think as a forward, you'd have to say, get it up, forward, get the puck up in the air, but a great save by Osgood.
These two netminders have done a good job tonight. Osgood hasn't been tested in quite a while. He passed that test with flying colors.
That's what you can purely call a save of the game. Especially seeing that San Jose has not had many chances.
Here come the Sharks again. Swimming into the Detroit zone. Ellis. Jason Moore is intercepted by Primo. Under 7 minutes to go in regulation time. Game seven time. Osgood backhand, but not out. The Sharks in the front. For the San Jose Sharks, Jamie Baker, who scored the first goal of the series, scores the biggest goal in the Sharks' history.
Well, one of the assets of Osgood isn't playing the puck after a brilliant save on Dolan. He gave the puck away, went out to the corner and played it, went to his backhand, and look at the anticipation of Baker, sensing there's an empty net. He just let it rip right to the far side and make no mistake about it. I'm not sure if Bob Airy tipped it in front, but Airy's in the crease right here. Bob Airy's right skate is in the crease before the puck enters the crease area, and I know he had nothing to do with the play.
Here comes Fedorov right back, but Baker breaks him up. They did give the goal to Jamie Baker, his second of the series, his first since game one here in Detroit.
Saw right after that play that Paul Coffey went over to Oscar and said, shake it off, pal, we need you.
Oh, it's up against the wall time for the number one seed in the Western Conference, the Detroit Red Wings. You think of the Sharks scoring, you don't think of Jamie Baker making too many big goals. He's not up there with Makarov and Kharkhamov and company. Boy, did he come up that time. Taking advantage of the odd good miss clear. Fedorov, an easy one in on Hervé, who hangs on. 5:50 to go. San Jose leading by one. Sergei Makarov, a goal and an assist. Chris Draper, big goal for the Detroit Red Wings. Jamie Baker, though, the biggest one of the series just a moment ago. The San Jose Sharks are less than 6 minutes away from advancing to the second round of the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Well, they've been a patient hockey club here so far. They've been patient, and Detroit has tried to come at them in every direction, but San Jose's clogged up the middle and hasn't given them very many opportunities for quality chances.
5.5 to go in regulation time. Here's Cicerelli, right wing. Fedorov breaks the net. He shoots Derby in the save, and Todd Ellis was there to clear away the rebound. Had somebody been in the slot for Detroit, the game would be tied. Arthur Hervé kept it a one-goal lead, but that save. Cicerelli can't hit Kozlov. Duchesne in the corner. Without a stick, rushes back to pick it up. Here's Kozlov breaking out of his own zone. Ball Coffey. Bob Airy gets there for San Jose.
Well, Coffey dumped it in, but they were going for a line change, so no forechecking, no pressure.
Here's Eisenman, but he's offside, says the linesman. Ray Scapinello and Scotty Bowman. That was made before the year started. He criticized the quality of his goaltender. Made the trade late in the season for Essendon. But it turned out all along that Osgood would turn out to be number one in this series. But it's ironic, isn't it, that an Osgood turnover handling the puck right now has Detroit in trouble.
Sergei Fedorov is one of the many weapons they have. Cicerelli on the pass to Fedorov, little backhander trying to go to the far side. But again, nobody in front of the net except for Todd Ellis. Again, the discipline of the San Jose Sharks taking care of their own zone. There's 4:37 left in this game. From Detroit's perspective, you can't just clearly go gamble, gamble, gamble. You don't want this to be a 4-2 hockey game. They've got enough weapons. They could still be patient, and every one of these lines, starting with Eisenman and Fedorov, can go to the net.
Here's Steve Chase on. Shepard, 4:28 and count. On the right point. The bumper on a pinball machine. That defense of San Jose just knocks it out. Here's Kharkhamov taking away from Konstantinov, and Kharkhamov pays for it. Sharks setting up now the Detroit zone. Red Wing fans getting impatient. Kharkhamov goes to the bench. He's hurting. Got hit by Aaron Klunk. Chase off. 3:50 to go.
The system of San Jose is perfect for this situation. They play that neutral zone trap, sort of a 1-2-2. And that's why the Detroit Red Wings right now, they can't get a pass across because the San Jose Sharks are clogging up that middle.
O'Donnell in the corner. Chris Draper trying to get it from him, and he does. Nice job of digging by Draper. Eisenman, back pass to Coffey. Coffey looking to center, behind the net. Back to Lindstrom, he'll let her rip. Hervé the save, and the rebound is off to his left, and Duchesne clears the zone. Oh boy,
Hervé again. So great goaltending can win it for you. Another great save by Arthur.
All of Archie in San Jose. Burr behind the net. Sends in front. Nobody home but the Sharks. Whitney. Under 3 minutes to go. A 2-on-2. Whitney with Airy. Whitney shoots off the poster, off the stick of Osgood. 1-2. Flames eliminated in this building, a home seventh game in overtime by the Toronto Maple Leafs. And they talked about that after evening the series of three. They didn't want to lose it in seven again. That was their motivation to play well tonight. Well, they haven't played terribly, but a key mistake as the Detroit Red Wings on the fence of elimination again. Time is running out on Sergei Fedorov. Time is running out on the other big guns of the Detroit Red Wings. Would Markel be able to quarterback a play that would result in the tying goal? Could Dino Cicerelli get in front of the net and tip one in? That's what the fans in this building are hoping for. They're not booing their team. They're getting into it, trying to spur them on. I think right now the Red Wings would take overtime and love it. Jason can't keep it in the zone.
How many times have the Detroit Red Wings made blind passes right to the middle? No one's home except for the Sharks.
Eisman tied up behind his own end momentarily. Here's Coffey on left wing. He'll dump it in. Kozlov. Four-man scrum. It comes to Elliott. And the Wings starting to take chances now. Under 2 minutes to play. We'll have to watch the Detroit net and see when Osgood comes out. This is Sandis Ozolin. And every time San Jose clears the zone, it buys him another 10 or 15 seconds. Under a minute and a half to go. Draper looks to the bench. He hasn't left yet. Or rather, Osgood looks to the bench. He hasn't left yet. He's coming out a little bit. Here's Cicerelli. Hervé, a stick save. Osgood out a little bit more. Coffey. Did he keep it in the zone?
No.
It came out over the blue line. Faceoff just outside the San Jose zone. And look at the Sharks. Oh, they can smell it. Just like sharks in the ocean.
They've been calm, cool, and collected this entire game. Now, I'm wondering right now which coach, Scotty Bowman, right now desperately needs a timeout with the faceoff just outside the blue line. His decision now would be, when do I pull the goaltender? And if I know Scotty's an experienced guy. This would be a perfect time for a timeout right now so we can discuss that with his goaltender.
Well, there you see it, head-to-head, when things were tight, the Sharks came out on top. But here you've got Detroit, Darren. They're the highest-scoring team of the NHL. There you have San Jose. They made the biggest one-year improvement in the NHL. This team won 11 games a year ago. This team was down as low as you could go. Only Ottawa was perceived as the worst franchise in the NHL. Here they are, a minute and 9 seconds away from knocking off these guys, the number one seed in the Western Conference, who are thought to be a legitimate challenger to the Rangers for the Stanley Cup. Go figure.
Start right away with the coaching change in San Jose. Kevin Constantine has established a system. He had many of these players in Kansas City. He added Wayne Thomas to his lineup in terms of coaching, and they believe in the system that they are playing. We're seeing it in the NHL. Systems are winning out. Red Wing fans right now are not.
And goaltenders are having an unbelievable playoff season. We've seen it around the league. Last minute of play in the third period and maybe the season for Detroit. And offside again as Eisman dumps it in with 56.6 seconds to go.
Jamie Baker right now is the hero for the San Jose Sharks. Many in San Jose say that through the course of the year he has been one heck of a trooper. Grinding it out. Jamie Baker last year played for the Ottawa Senators after scoring 19 goals last year in Ottawa. The option's a free agent to San Jose, and he's found himself a home.
Played his college hockey at St. Lawrence in upstate New York. He scored the first goal of the series. He may have scored the last. Osgood's out. Detroit has six attackers on, trying desperately to tie. Cicerelli around the boards. Coffey has to keep it in. Had no shot to the point. Cicerelli looking. Primo's in front. Loose puck. Hervé finding it and covering it up with 31.8 seconds to go. Well, a little bit over a week ago, we saw the St. Louis Blues in a game against Dallas tie it up in under 30 seconds. You see Scotty Bowman signaling for his timeout.
Again, Detroit keeping the puck in deep, trying to play it in front to Big Keith Primo. Shepard's also in front, trying to bang away the loose puck, but again, four San Jose Sharks, five Red Wings in that one area, and Hervé is able to hang on to it from behind the net again. See little Tom Peterson trying to take out Keith Primo, does an excellent job of eliminating the man, and Primo's unable to get a shot back on the backhand. And then Hervé's able to cover it up, but for Scotty Bowman and the Red Wings, the key faceoff man down the stretch in this game has been the captain. Steve Yzerman has won 11 of his last 15 faceoffs in this game, and obviously with 31.8 left on the clock, it is absolutely essential that the Red Wings win the faceoff. If the Red Wings are not to win the faceoff and San Jose clears the zone, you can all but write this one off. That will clearly kill 15 to 17 seconds off the clock.
Arthur Zerbe, he has faced 29 Detroit Red Wing shots. And he has really shown his mettle because he gave up most of those seven goals on Thursday night. There is no goaltender in the Detroit net, is there? All right. The fans of Detroit, I got to give them the nod. 20,000 on their feet. Not going, supporting their Red Wings.
Yzerman looks like he's going to go up against Larionov. Larionov's only won 3 of 10. Yzerman 11 of 15.
Yzerman wins the draw. Can Coffey keep it in? Yes, it's onside. The shot, a save in front. There is a Cicerelli with a loose puck, but he couldn't jam it in the net. And the Sharks clear the zone. 20 seconds to go. Stunned, the crowd, happy, the Sharks, happy, that's an understatement. The agony of a favorite not performing once again, and the money is on the table, Darren.
Fourth year, they've lost in the seventh game, in the first round, they've lost three of now, the last four. Hats off to the San Jose Sharks for believing in what they're all about, for playing a kind of system. All the way through, they never once couldn't believe that they could win this.
San Jose will advance, Detroit will go home, and you have to wonder if some of the big wheels on this Red Wing machine will be put on a lift and rotated out of town. These fans expected a Stanley Cup this year. I can assure you the fans in San Jose, and they're wonderful and they're loyal, they never expected this.
They haven't, and Arthur Zerbe, a guy that deserves an awful lot of congratulations, was terrific. But that really wasn't the difference. That wasn't the story with San Jose. The story was the belief in what they were all about. And as a team, as a unit, they believed they could beat the Detroit Red Wings.
And there's the hero, Jamie Baker, shaking hands with one of the Detroit assistant coaches, Barry Smith. A very bitter night here in Detroit, but they are partying in San Jose, California. And Darren, it looks like you and I eventually are going to find our way to San Jose.
Here they've got a beautiful arena.
There's the goaltender Osgood, whose mishandling of the puck led to the goal by Jamie Baker. There are the San Jose Sharks. Their miracle has come true for Chris Osgood. Disappointed.
To wrap it up, let's see if Harrah can do it like he did in the first leg. This to conclude these successful championships here at Linz. 38 points needed to bring it all to a successful conclusion. There's 19. Another one of those will do nicely. Yes, indeed. So Spreitzer and Harrah win the doubles. The end of a great series of...